Welcome to an all-new series on Lambda Test on Selenium with C# and SpecFlow. In this series, we'll talk enough details on SpecFlow and Selenium to integrate with Lambda Test platform. So in this whole series, we'll cover setting up SpecFlow in your local machine and how to integrate it with SpecFlow and run test locally, and running parallel test with SpecFlow and running SpecFlow test with Selenium to run on Lambda test platform. And in this video, we'll be talking about the SpecFlow's introduction and installation. SpecFlow is the popular .NET open source framework for behavioral driven development. And SpecFlow is the cucumber for .NET framework. And SpecFlow has got a lot of advantages, like it helps to bridge the gap between QA, BA, dev, and stakeholders. Because this is a BDD based tool, it will help the whole team to talk same language by literally making the whole user requirement as a user readable text for whole QA, BA, dev, and stakeholders. SpecFlow has powerful integration with Visual Studio IDE as well, which helps you to get all the rich SpecFlow's baked-in feature within Visual Studio IDE, making the SpecFlow test execution and SpecFlow test scenario writing very easy. And SpecFlow can run test in both IDE and in command line interface, not just in sequence, but also in parallel as well as in tagged version of it. And SpecFlow is the .NET Core compatible framework, meaning it can run the test on Windows, macOS, and Linux operating system, and making SpecFlow as a cross-platform tool. So these are the major advantages of the SpecFlow in a nutshell. And SpecFlow sample scenario is going to look something like this, and that's what we'll be creating in this whole series. As you can see, the SpecFlow scenario will have a scenario or scenario outline, and then there is a given, when, then statements in the scenario, and it has a table structures like browser, browser versions, and operating system, and it'll also have examples as we are using scenario outline, which helps you to run multiple different tests same time for same scenario. Well, as that said, the setup and prerequisite of SpecFlow is going to be very simple as well. All you need to have is Visual Studio 2017 or above within your machine installed, and then SpecFlow extension installed, and Selenium reference installed within your machine. So once you have all these prerequisite software, then you are pretty good to go with getting started and work with SpecFlow within your machine. So in this video, we are gonna start setting up SpecFlow with Visual Studio 2019, and we'll see how we can create a very super simple project. So now I'm in my Windows 10 machine, and I'm gonna be opening the Visual Studio 2019. And within Visual Studio 2019, the first thing we need to do is to install the SpecFlow's extension. In order to install the SpecFlow's extension, you can just hit this continue without code option, and then you can go all the way to the extensions and go to the manage extensions option. I have already installed the SpecFlow within my Visual Studio, but just for the demonstration, I'm going to show you how you can install SpecFlow from this extensions. Just go to the online and search for SpecFlow. You can see there is a SpecFlow for Visual Studio 2019. Well, this is the extension which I was talking about that you need to be installing within your Visual Studio so that you get a lot of different advantages. Like you can get the project template of SpecFlow. You can also see the logo coming in of the SpecFlow. And also you can run the SpecFlow test within Visual Studio along with its powerful IntelliSense options. So once this is installed, you can then start creating the project. Just go to the file, go to the new, and go to the project. This is going to start asking you which project that you're going to be creating. You can just search for SpecFlow, and this project template is coming up because we have installed the extension within our Visual Studio. And once we have this SpecFlow project template, you can just select this and hit next, and then start creating the new project from here. So I'm going to be creating a project called as Lambda Test SpecFlow Selenium, and I'm just going to hit create. And then it'll ask you which framework that you're going to be choosing with. Is it going to be a .NET Core 3.1 framework or the full .NET framework, which is nothing but .NET 5. I'm just going to be leaving with the .NET Core 3.1 framework, And the test framework you can choose as well, like XUnit, NUnit, MSTest, or SpecFlow Plus Runner, because SpecFlow Plus Runner is free at the moment. I'm just going to choose the NUnit because we have already discussed about NUnit in our Lambda test series. You can watch our Lambda test series on NUnit with Selenium integration, where we have already discussed a lot of detail about it. So I'm just going to choose the test framework as NUnit, and I'm just going to hit create. So this is going to create the SpecFlow project for me within my Visual Studio. And once you create this project, if you go to the Solution Explorer, you can also see that it is going to create a structure for you of SpecFlow project, along with resolving all the dependencies for you, like NUnit, NUnit 3 test adapter, specflow.nunit, specflow plus living doc plugin. And it also added a fluent assertion that we can use for the assertion purposes. It also created a features folder and a hooks folder and a step definitions folder, which can help us to write the step definitions. And because this is already a feature file and it already has the test in it, we can literally see the test bin coming up if we do a build solution. So this is the way that we can actually create our first project of SpecFlow within Visual Studio, and then we can start writing the actual test of SpecFlow along with Selenium in our next video.
In case you have any questions or you require any further information, you can chat with the team, or you can also drop us an email at support@lambdatest.com. We're here to help and we'd love to hear from you.
Subscribe to our channel to stay on top of exciting features on your way. Happy testing!